welcome to our teaching point on preliminary analysis. We are starting with a compensated data set. You can see that the compensation has been applied. This was discussed in a previous video. Now, the first thing that we're going to do is start our gating strategy. And when we gate, some of the things that we want to do initially are use a variety of gates to clean up the data, eliminate potential issues that were caused because of staining problems, sample preparation problems, running problems, as well as take advantage of a dump channel and viability gate to reduce the number of events that we have to analyze. We want to get rid of those extraneous events that may cause problems in our downstream analysis. So the first thing I like to do is run a plugin called FlowAI. These are several different plugins. FlowAI and FlowClean are two of them that allow you to automatically identify anomalies in your data set and remove them. These anomalies can be due to issues with how the sample was run, due to microclogging, things of that nature. So after I save my sample, I'm going to go into the plugin and I'm going to run FlowAI. Now, if you don't know about plugins or you don't have any plugins, you can go to the FlowJo website and FlowJo Exchange and download these plugins. And you can see from my list, there's a large number of them. So we're going to click on that. It's going to open up this dialog box, which is going to ask us what parameters we're going to be using. And I do not change any of these parameters. So I hit OK, and I let the software start to run. Once FlowAI has completed its run, it will produce two populations, FlowAI bad and FlowAI good events. Now, you'll see that from our total sample of 486,000, it identified 146,000 events that it considered bad. So let's take a look at these events, and we're going to double-click on the bad events, and we're going to set up, I typically use forward scatter versus time, and you'll notice that there looks like a lot of jumping going on here. If we look at the good events, again, time versus forward scatter, you see a nice even run. If you compare the two of those, you can see at the beginning here there's a lot of discontinuity. We have breaks, and this may be due in part because this data was run on a high throughput sampler, and as the system doesn't always stabilize quickly, we see this type of instability. So we're going to now continue on with this data here to do our second analysis and continue down our gating. So our first gate is our flow stability gate, and you can do this manually, but again, I prefer using the automated methods. So now we're going to look at flow height versus flow area. This is a BD instrument, so we know that our data should be along the diagonal based upon the area scaling factor. These cells up here, which have a higher area compared to the height, are presumptive doublets. So we're going to gate along this population here. Just going to draw a gate like this. Eliminate stuff right at the top. Eliminate stuff right at the bottom. And there we go. Our next gate from here will be what I like to call the Schmutz removal gate, or the forward scatter or side scatter that many people use. Now, you'll notice when I do a forward scatter or side scatter gate, I tend to grab the main population here. I'm going to eliminate these cells down here. These are debris and junk, and smell cells along this axis here, which are small pycnotic cells. We're going to eliminate the cells up here and along the side, but we're going to keep the most of the population here. Again, gating is a data reduction tool, and we want to make sure we don't eliminate anything that we might want to look at. Fortunately, we can always go and do a back gate analysis to see if we missed something or incorrectly placed our gate. So we're just going to use a large gate here. I'm going to bring it up, leaving out that debris at the top. Bring it over here, and closing it here. And you can call this what you want. And if I want to do that, I can just change this by coming over here and renaming. make it a better name, Cells of Interest. Now we'll double click through here. And the last of the gates that I like to use in this initial setup is to gate out the dead cells, which were identified by our live dead yellow, and use our dump channel here. So now you can see we've got dump channel positive cells here, dead cells here, and we're going to gate on this. You may notice that our population looks a little bit, we haven't optimized our transformation. If we come over to this button here, we can customize the axis, and that does give us this population here and lets us play with the biexponential scaling and adjust the width base. You can do that a couple of different ways. You can use this width down here, or you can use these buttons up here. I tend to adjust the width base down here, bring the width base up. Now, what I'm looking for is as few to minimize the number of events that are off scale here. When I apply the gate, we now have a separation. There's a little bit left there. If we go back, we can try to customize that a bit more. And so we're going to grab this population here, and we're going to ignore the rest of this population. So we'll just take a nice gate like this. I'll call these live cells. And now we've done our preliminary gating analysis, we would move on to our secondary gating analysis, where we actually start to use the antibodies of interest to analyze our data.